Hi everyone, welcome to Spice and Pans. If you like our channel, please hit subscribe and thank you for watching.
Hi and welcome to Spice and Pans. Today I'm going to show you how to make Hokkien fried noodles, or what they call it, Fujian 炒面. So these are the basic ingredients that we have over here. I have a packet of bihun over here, or vermicelli. Some noodles, yellow noodles. Clean up cuttlefish. These are prawns. I've actually taken out the head. Later I just need to fry them and put them in the broth. As you can see, I have a lot of prawn heads over here. These are some of the remains from the last
five spice roll
that we did. Okay. I have over here some Thai meat also, or thui ba. You can use pork belly or lean meat if you want to. Good try later for frying the noodles. Eggs, of course, we'll be using more than this, I'm just showing you.
Yes.
And garlic, later we'll chop this up. I have over here also ikan bilis concentrated stock, or anchovies. This is to put about 2 tablespoons inside the broth itself. And this is for frying the noodles later. Some fish sauce. And of course, sugar to taste in the broth itself. These are some of the water that I boiled. I've added in about 2 tablespoons of the ikan bilis concentrated stock. While it's boiling, I'll just add in these 2 pieces of Thai meat that I've cleaned up earlier on. We just put the cover on and let it boil for approximately about half an hour. While we're waiting for the pork to cook, let me just warm up this pan. We are going to fry the prawn heads. Make sure that the pan is hot. How to know whether the pan is hot? One is, of course, put your hand near the pan itself, and the other is to use visually. If the oil is moving freely, it means that the oil is hot already. Okay. So I'm going to fry the prawn heads. I'm going to separate into 2 batch because it's a little bit too much over here. Be careful when doing this because it might just splatter. Now this step is actually to ensure that the fragrance of the prawn head actually comes out. Make sure you really cook this, because if you do it halfway, it might just have this fishy smell in your broth. Just spread it out and let it just cook for a while. So just stir it around, make sure that all the heads are being cooked. We can see that the color has changed to orange. That means that it's actually cooked already. So what I do now is I like to actually extract the juices out of the head. So what I'll do is I'll add some stock, some boiling stock, to the pan itself. While it is boiling, I like to use a potato masher to actually mash the head a little bit to get the juices out. Get the maximum flavor possible out from these beautiful heads. Now if you are using a stick-proof pan, just be careful, don't scratch it. You can see actually the broth over here is turned a milky orange color, which means that all the flavor are into the broth as well. So after this, stir around a little bit. I'm just going to pour everything back into the big pot of broth. Don't worry about the pork that's boiling inside there. Just let it boil. We're going to do the same again for the second batch of prawn head. So, same thing, add some oil, heat it up. Now that the stock is boiling, I'll put in the cuttlefish to boil also. Just put them on a strainer like this and just put in for a couple of minutes.
Cuttlefish cook pretty fast, so you don't have to cook it for too long time. Just cook for a little while and it will be done. Once you see that it turns completely opaque like this, it's done. Alright, so I'll just scoop this up, strain it out. And that's the cuttlefish. So I'm going to do the same for the prawns also, but I'm going to do them in batches because that's a little bit too much if I were to throw them all in at once. I want them to be succulent and very crunchy, so I'm just putting maybe about 6 or 7 at a time. Shake them up a little bit. I can see that they are turning orangey. When the water is boiling up again, right, it's about done. Let's shake it for a couple more seconds. Right, this is how it's done. I'll just repeat for the rest of the prawns itself. So while you are cooking the prawns, you can just soak the vermicelli in a pot of water to soften it up so that you can fry it later on. I've also purchased $2 worth of pork lard. I will need the oil for frying the noodles in it. It will impart a very nice fragrance and taste to a noodle. But if you want a healthy version, then just use normal vegetable oil or groundnut oil. How to make crispy pork lard? It is actually very simple, but there's some important steps that we need to go through. First is to wash your pork lard and drain it dry and cut into smaller pieces like this. And you must wait for your pan to be hot. So what you do is just scrape everything that you have into the pan. Now the important thing in having this crispy pork lard is to add salt. I'm going to put in approximately about 1 teaspoon of salt inside here. This will actually help to dehydrate the pork lard. I make it very crispy. You don't have to put any oil inside there because this will naturally extract the oil out from the pork lard itself. So just stir it around. Just put it in a pan and stir it around approximately every once every 2 or 3 minutes itself. Now how do we know that it's done? Basically you will see that all these steps will shrink to very small pieces and they all float up without much of this seasoning sound or even some bubbles around. Then they'll be done. I'll show it later when it's done to you. Halfway through frying, you can see there's a lot of bubbles coming up. It's not done yet. I guess it takes another about maybe 15 to 20 minutes more. You can see that it has shrunken considerably in size. But we need to brown properly, and for now you have to actually turn down the heat a little bit lower because we want to extract all the oil out and make the lard as crispy as possible. Now the next we do, I've taken out the cork already and I just need to taste the broth itself, make sure that it's the taste is good. Oh, it's really fresh. The aroma of the prawn is fantastic. Now what I do over here is I'll add approximately about 2 teaspoons of sugar and 1 teaspoon of salt. Stir it around for a little bit and we are done with the broth. So as you can see, when it has browned nicely and there's less bubble coming up, that means that it's done. So what we need to do now is just scoop this up. I'm going to put this separately off from the oil because the oil you can use it to fry vegetables, noodles or whatever, and it what our ancestor or what our forefather did last time. And it tastes really good. So just drain the oil out, put aside. I'm waiting for the oil to cool down before I transfer it to a container so I can use it time and time again. Now we'll start showing you how to pan fry the fried Hokkien noodles. First, heat up a pan. Add in some oil. Don't worry about having too much oil right now at this moment because we're going to fry the egg first. I'm cooking for 3 right now, so I'm putting in approximately 7 eggs. Make sure that the oil is getting hot. Once you can feel the heat coming up, it's time to put it in. Now how much eggs you use is entirely up to you, but we love eggs. So we're gonna put a little bit more eggs than the usual. The good thing about cooking all this at home is you get to decide how much ingredient you want, how salty you want it to be, and things like that. Throw the egg around a little bit. I like to char them a little so the taste will be really, really very nice. So I'm just going to leave them here for a couple of seconds. Now I remove some of the eggs because my wife likes to have it slightly wetter in the clay pot, so I'm keeping some eggs for her. After this is done, put the egg aside. Then add some more oil and fry the garlic. I like the taste of garlic, so I'm going to put it a little bit more. So when you smell the garlic smell coming up and it's starting to brown, it's time to add in the vermicelli. At this point of time, you can add in some of the stock first to soften the vermicelli, or bihun as we call it. The reason I'm not cooking it together with the noodles, yellow noodles at this point of time is I want to soften the vermicelli first and not to mash up the noodle way too much. Right, I can see now the bihun is actually softened already. It's time for me to add in the yellow noodles. Add some more of the broth. We are going to part steam the noodles and get the goodness of the broth into the noodles and the vermicelli. So I'm just going to put a little bit more. And we're going to cover them up for approximately about 3 to 5 minutes. Now about 3 to 5 minutes are up. So let's open this up. Have a look. You can see that most of the sauce has already been absorbed. I'll just put a little bit more broth because I like my noodles a little bit wet. it's time to add in the main ingredients. I have squid over here, as well as pork and prawns. Put all of them in. A handful of chive. You can skip this if you don't like the taste of chive, but I love it, so I'm going to put it in. At this point of time, splash in some fish sauce. You can use soy sauce if you don't have fish sauce, but I like fish sauce taste with noodles, so it's very good. Not too much because it's a little bit salty. Stir them out. You can see how beautiful this dish is. Now sometimes when you eat outside, they tend to use those thicker bee hoon. For me, I like the small ones because it actually absorbs the sauce very, very well. We are about done. And it's time to scoop them up. And there you have it, the end results to the Hokkien fried noodles. We have the dry type over here. For condiments, we have chili, sambal belacan, lime and pork lard, and here's the wet version which my wife loved. If you enjoy our video, do click like on the video and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching Spice and Pans. Thank you.